understanding the Japanese mindset. Japan's health and labor minister has defended employers who require women to wear high heels to work. A group of women had submitted a petition to the Japanese government to protest against near obligation of wearing high heels in offices and workplaces. I featured this story in my previous video this week. If you haven't watched it, I'll put the link below. Asked for a comment, Minister Takumi Nemoto said, "It's socially accepted as something that falls within the realm of being occupationally necessary and appropriate." This is the minister. Campaigners said wearing high heels was considered to be near obligatory when job hunting or working at many Japanese companies. The campaign is called KuToo, hashtag KUTOO. The Guardian carries an article by journalist Summer Brennan. She says high heels have been a key component of female power dressing for decades, and plenty of women not only choose to wear high heels, but passionately defend that choice. Indeed, high heels can be used as a means to express femininity, often in the corporate world. But look at the Japanese boardrooms. At listed companies, women account for merely 3.7% of all executives. The figures were 34.4% for France, 23.2% for the UK, and 17.9% for the US in 2015. What does this mean? What do you think? To me, it's about choice. It's about being yourself rather than being someone else, being forced to be. If you like this story, please subscribe and hit the notification button below. I'm Kenji. Understanding the Japanese mindset. See you in the next video. Bye.